Welcome to the Crazy Hat Chemist. So today we're doing the last video on thermochemistry. Bam! We're going to do a bomb calorimetry calculation here today. So here's our problem. We're going to calculate the number of calories in 88 grams of Cheerios, assuming complete combustion of those Cheerios, if the temperature rises from 24.1 to 30.3 degrees Celsius. There is 50.0 grams of water inside the calorimeter, and the heat capacity of the bomb is 1.26 joules per Kelvin. Remember, Kelvin and degrees Celsius have the same interval, so the change in temperature is the same whether it's Kelvin or degrees Celsius. Okay, we're going to then determine the number of calories in 1 gram of a Cheerio. So let's see if we can do this problem here. So we first need an equation. Now, I haven't given you this equation yet before, but here it is. The Q total is equal to the Q for the calorimeter plus the Q for the bomb. The Q for the bomb is generally given to you when you purchase the bomb, and it's given to you in this problem. That is, the heat capacity of the bomb is 1.26 joules per Kelvin. When you purchase a bomb calorimeter, that number is a standard value. That is the amount of energy that is not able to be determined using that measuring device. One way to use this and determine it yourself is take your nested styrofoam cups or your calorimeter that is on the previous video, fill it up with a certain temperature of water, and let that water cool over time and take the measurements of that over time, and you will get the heat capacity of that bomb. That is the amount of energy that is lost, but you can't yet determine it. Okay? So we're going to fill in a little bit what Q is equal to for each one of those, do a little substitution. The Q total is the sum of the two, obviously, but the Q for the calorimeter is going to be the mass of the water times the specific heat capacity for water times the change in temperature of the water plus that for the bomb, and it's the heat capacity for the bomb times the change in temperature. The change in temperature is going to be the same under both circumstances. You're going to take that 30.3 degrees Celsius minus the 24.1. They both have one decimal place. You're going to have one decimal place. Okay? The mass of the water is 50 grams. The specific heat of water is 4.184 joules per gram degrees Celsius. And the change in temperature is 6.2 degrees Celsius. The heat capacity of the bomb is that 1.26 joules per degree Celsius, which is the same as joules per Kelvin. And then the change in temperature is the same. We're going to cancel all the units out here. We're going to have joules, and we're going to get a numeric value here for this. This is the amount of energy that's released because this is a combustion reaction. So that means that this is actually a negative value. So I could say negative 1,300 joules or just 1,300 joules released or liberated. So that word released lets me know that that's a negative value if I didn't have the word there. Okay, we need to convert this into calories, and the calorie to joule conversion is right there. That is the specific heat of water, right? And now that is 312 calories within those 88 grams of Cheerios. Well, I'm supposed to get the calories per gram of Cheerios. So we're going to divide this number by the number of grams of Cheerios in which we're inside the bomb. And this will give me the calories per gram of a Cheerio. And so that is 3.54 calories per gram of a Cheerio. So there's your answer there. This is how we determine the calories in a food substance, whatever that is. Okay? That was an awesome video. That is the last video in this series of thermochemistry. I am the Big Cheese. If you like that video, give me a thumbs up. Thumbs up, please. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I greatly appreciate that. Look for many other videos on my YouTube channel, even in Honors Chemistry. Have a great day. I'll see you next time. Bye now.